child, I know you're hurt and you can't let go. It's not your fault and you don't deserve.
Yeah, I'd seen a lot of people doing it and it looked really cool, and then we looked it up and did a ton of research and asked other van lifers their opinions, and we just started putting things into motion, started selling things pretty much right away.
We knew the wheelbase we wanted, we knew the dimensions, and Jana was just like wild getting everything and figuring it all out. So we pretty much had the idea of what it was going to look like, at least a floor plan.
Pretty early on. Yeah,
pretty early on. Well, we bought it July 16th of 2018.
About 8 months. And we finished in March.
March of 19, so yeah, about 8 months.
I'm Jake.
I'm Gianna.
That's Luna.
That's our two-year-old daughter, Luna.
And this is our van, Vanessa.
Vanessa.
We have a 2011 Freightliner Sprinter with a V6 turbo diesel engine made by Mercedes-Benz. We have just some upgraded footwear on there, put a little more traction on there. We have a pull-out awning on top. It cranks out to about 8 feet, as well as a wireless internet by Togo on there, which is pretty cool. We also have a 1100 watt air conditioner that we use a generator. I'll show you in the back. Wi-Fi is made by Togo, and that's through WineGuard is the company, and it is pretty awesome. It allows us to work on the road, and the service is AT&T. We carry our two bicycles as well, and 2 5-gallons of fuel, one diesel and one for our generator. This is our generator. It is a Craftsman 3000 watt generator that helps run the air conditioner and hot water heater. We also have our kid carrier backpack from Deuter, which is awesome. This is our battery box. So in our battery box are 2 300-hour AGM batteries. We have 300 watts of solar that tie into those. Over here is our water tank. So we carry 20 gallons of fresh water there and then carry 4 gallons in our hot water heater. The Phillips are right on the side of the vehicle there, and we also have a shore power plug. So these are our bug screens. We got these off Amazon, and they're pretty awesome. They're magnetic, so they close together and pretty much keep everything out. It's a really awesome feature and allows us to kind of go anywhere. Having that and the air conditioning, don't have to worry about hot summers in the south. And this is pretty much our garage. It holds everything else. Luna's stroller, chairs, my toolbox is underneath there. All that fun stuff, you know, dump hose, everything fun.
All right, welcome to my home. So when we were designing the van, we wanted it to, you know, it's a super small space, so we wanted it to feel as open as possible. We knew we were going to do a lot of white, keep it white and bright. We wouldn't change anything about the layout. We made use of pretty much every possible corner we could. It feels like home. It's really nice to, you know, go out and adventure all day and then see our van in the parking lot and know that it's everything we need is right with us. And it's really a small space, but it's homey. It's our home. We have some plants here. Started off with herbs, a little herb garden, and they didn't last long on the road. And so I moved on to succulents, and I still can't keep those alive. So we will see what else. Maybe some fake plants to get in there. Here in our entryway is our refrigerator. Just a tiny little dorm-sized fridge. We built this to be like kind of a get-ready station. We have our mirror, so you know, we don't have a bathroom, but it still works. This is our silverware drawer. Perfect spot right above the fridge. So this is our overhead storage, which we absolutely needed. This is where Jake and I store our clothes. So in this giant bin, and then undies and socks and stuff go in there. This is Luna's section. We had this seat installed. Jake actually found it from a U-Pole junkyard, and then we had it reupholstered. And up here are all of Luna's clothes and sweaters and bathing suits. It's kind of her whole little section. And then down here on the side of her seat is her toy box, which is built in here, easily accessible for her to get all of her own toys. This is our favorite feature of the van, and this is our pull-out slide-out pantry. This is wonderful. We have tons of storage on here, all of our dry goods for the most part. It is a wonderful use of space my uncle and I came up with. So this is our overflow of dry goods and our plates, cups, measuring cups. We had 2 coffee mugs, but one came flying out and broke. So we'll come up with a different solution for that. This is kind of where we keep our toiletries, and we have our solar controller in here so we can check our batteries and see how much solar power we're getting at any given time. This is our electronics cabinet. So we have our drone and gimbal and random things. things. All right, this is our propane stove. We run it off of a 1 gallon propane tank, which is just here, and it's vented down through the ceiling so that it could, through the floor, so it could breathe. Our countertops are Corian. They're solid surface. They're wonderful. We absolutely love these countertops. And then this is actually a bathroom sink that we undermounted to act as a farmhouse kitchen sink. It's one of my favorite features here. We chose a flexible backer board. It is real tile backsplash. We don't have any cracks or anything, so we're pumped about that. This is our utensil drawer. Everything has the drawers are a little difficult to pull out, so it's kind of nice. They don't come flying open when you're driving. Jake's knives are in this drawer. They get their own drawer. And then here is our junk drawer, although we try to keep it organized. Under our sink is our pretty decent sized garbage can, which is wonderful. And then we have a hot water heater. It's a 4.5 gallon hot water heater. So we just turn it on for about 5 minutes before we need hot water, and it's ready for us. Okay, so this is our teeny tiny bathroom. It's a shower toilet combination. We have a flush toilet that goes down into a black tank, which is actually stored down here. And so the whole room is waterproof. And then we have a Nautilus shower door to close it up. And we have a little light and a shelf, and it's perfect. We definitely love having a bathroom in this van. Absolute necessity, especially with a 2-year-old. All right, we also have a 15-inch closet. It's also where we have our AC, and we can check on our inverter. Under the bed here is our hatch. So once it's opened up, you have access to our garage if we need to crawl in there, and it's where we keep our dirty clothes, and so they're out of our living space. This is our sleeping arrangements. Jake and my bed is here. It is a custom size mattress that we ordered through Custom Mattress Factory. It's wonderful, any shape or size you need. Up here is Luna's bed. It is her little Luna loft, we call it. She has a shelf here to store her water bottle at night, and then a built-in pajama bin, which is here. So she has all of her nighttime essentials right next to her bed. So this is her, it's just a little decorative piece that says, "Dreams don't work unless you do," which is for sure. And then Luna painted these. So it's kind of her little shelf to display her artwork if she chooses.
It can be trying at some point. Some days you don't get anything done. Some days are just a complete wash. And then some days are just the magical experience getting to share it with everybody. And
every morning she wakes up and she asks where we are. And it's exciting to her to take the shades out of the windows and see. A lot of times we park at cool playgrounds. So she wakes up and she's like, oh.
At a playground. If you have a great relationship, I think it's going to help to build it. And if you're, you know, maybe on the rocks a little bit.
It'll test you. It's a small space. And so little things that we have that get on each other's nerves, we have to learn to just let it go and not let it bother us. We love this lifestyle. It comes with its challenges and little things, but as does a home, maintaining a house. And you just have to learn to roll with the punches and take it day by day and understand how lucky we are to be able to see the things we see and just go wherever you want. It's really nice. Yeah, it's our favorite. And our backyard changes every day, which is
a big backyard.
Huge backyard. Tiny house, huge backyard. We did start a YouTube channel, our VanQuest. We're hoping to just be a resource for those looking to live van life. You know, it's not so much vlog style. It's more like you come to find out information on where to find fresh water or safe places to sleep at night. Am I supposed to just keep going? Okay, I don't know if I'm supposed to stop in between.
Yeah, no,
all right, should I do up here?
Yeah, talk about
it
up there for sure.
Okay, all right, so we, just so you know, we dropped a bottle of soy sauce on our sink and it shattered. So we're in the process of putting a new one in. So don't focus on that one. I'm sorry for the things that I said while you were backing up the van.
Yeah.
It's a real, that meme out there is for real. It's kind of
so scary.
And we've actually had a wellness check on her before. Someone, a police officer.
And a DCF person came
in. They came and checked to make sure they heard there was a child living in a white van.
Yeah, so.
And then they saw it and they were like, okay.
Yeah.
You're
right.
This is great.